name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. Thank you, Prophet Jacob. Thank you so much. Thank you for coming. Thank you for joining. God bless you. And I'm going to look from the book of Ephesians, the book of Ephesians 5 verse 23. The Bible says, remember the powers of the fathers. Father has power. So the book of Ephesians 5 verse 23, the Bible says, For the husband is the head of the wife, as the Christ is the head of the church, his body or which is the Savior. So, if Paul is saying that the husband, the father, is the head of the wife, as Christ is the head of the church. So, fathers are the head of the wife, because fathers are the one who were first were created. Then the wife became number two. Now, we respect them and we honor them. We thank God for them. So we respect them and we love them so much, because God himself is the one who made them the head. So they have power. When God created them, he gave them power. He gave them special power. So this is the special power that we see in the Bible. Hallelujah. We are going to look in the book of Genesis 27. Genesis 27, we'll see how the power of the fathers works. And we will see what the power the father has to his children. Now, when you look at the book of Genesis 27, the Bible says, when Isaac grew old and his eyesight was falling, he summoned his older son, Hazor, and said to him, my son. And they said, here I am. He said, I am old and I do not know when I will die. So now take your hunting sword, your bow and the craft of the arrows, go out to the field and hunt a game for me. Make me the delicious food that I love and bring it to me so I can eat. Then I can bless before I die. I can bless you before I die. There is the blessings of the father. Here is a man called Isaac. Isaac, he was old, he was aged man. And he told his son, his firstborn son, that go and get me a food. Go and get me animals. Cook me a delicious food that I love so that I can bless you before I die. So Isaac, the father knows that he has power. He has a blessing to depart to bless his children before he died. So, and that's why we know that there's a blessings of the father. That father has power. Father has power. There's power coming from the father. And this power, you don't have to choke with it. That's why I'm talking to the ladies. I'm talking to the women. Please, women, the fathers, they have power for their children. So even if you don't like them, even if divorce has come, the fathers hurt you so much. I want to let you know that don't hide the children. Don't take away the children from the father. I know sometimes it's very abusive. It's very so bad. But if the father, even if it's what, God has given them special power to bless their children. Now, look at that. Rebecca was listening when Isaac spoke to his son. Hazor, and Hazor went out to the field to hunt a game, to hunt animals to bring back. Rebecca said to her son Jacob, I just heard your father saying to your brother Hazor, bring me some animals and make me some delicious food so I can eat and bless you in the Lord's presence before I die. So Rebecca heard what the father was talking to his son Esau, and Rebecca told Jacob that, Jacob, I want you to get this blessing, because me, I don't have the blessings that I can bless you. So he twisted Esau. Hallelujah, praise be the name of Jesus. Now, my son, Listen to me, to what I am telling you to do. Go to the flock and get me 2 healthy young goats so I can prepare them as the delicious food for your father loves. You can bring it to your father. He will eat and he will bless you before he die. You see now, Rebecca is bleeding to her son to obey her voice, to obey her. Now Jacob understood the consequences and the problem that would affect him if he's going to do what the mother is telling him to do. Now you can see here, Jacob said to his mother, Rebecca, my brother Esau is hairy man, but I have smooth skin. What if my father touches me and thinks I am making fun of him? I will be cursed instead of blessing. So the problem is that Jacob understood about the consequences which would affect him. He feared the curse that would fall upon him if he deceived his father. Now, Jacob was right. Jacob was right because those father has a curse. He can curse you, and this curse, it will never get out of your life. Now, because of the curses, Jacob feared, and he told his mother, "Mother, I know I'm going to do these things, but what am I going to do? This curse will come upon me. How am I going to come out of this curse?" His mother told him, "Your curse will be on me, my son. Just listen to me." You see, the mother said that the curse will be upon her. You see, God have mercy upon mothers. Mothers who deceive their children, even keep their children away from their fathers. Who deceive their fathers, who tells their children wicked. You don't have to tell your children against their father. I know that maybe you are so upset and you are so offended. You feel bad. When the marriage is breaking up, I know it's very bitter. But you know, when you make your child to hate your father, to hate their father, and the father is alive, remember that you are destroying your children with your own hand. Mothers, you are destroying your children with your own hand. Let the father have his children, and let the children and the father bless the children. I know some fathers are so wicked, yes. They can curse the children when they don't listen. I have experience with my husband and my children. So sometimes when you are fighting or when things are not right together, always the mother is with the children, and you tell your children what the father is abusing you, what the father is doing to you. So because of that, the children, they start hating their father and love their mother. And children who do not think properly, they will come to the side of the mother more 100% than the father. Now they can give the father like 25%, and the mother has taken 75%. They can give the mother up to 95%, then they give father 5%. When the father sees that, then the father will issue a curse. He will start hate those kids. He will start abusing them. And the thing is, the secret of the mother is that mothers influence the children. Now, because if the mother is the one who nurses the children, the mother is the one who takes care of the children. Now the children, they fear even the father. They say, "Is that what the father is doing? Oh, I don't like that." Now, because of that, and then the father says, "Okay, I have seen you, woman. You will suffer with your children." So some fathers, they really curse the mother and the children. Now, that's why you see so many children are suffering. Fatherless children, they suffer so much. I'm sorry for the fatherless children, the father who have died. Some children, like now, they feel very bitter when their parents, when the other children are pressing their fathers and thank their fathers. Some are leaving God. But here we are talking the case of Jacob and his mother. Who deceived, who make Jacob to enter into sin? You can make your children to enter into sin and to receive the curses. So I am talking about this because that is what is happening when divorce is there, and when even if it is not divorce, sometimes you see the mother tells the children how bad father is, but the mother does not tell the children how bad she is. She always talks bad about the father in front of the children. Sit the children together and start gossiping the father. Then the children feel very bitter towards the father. And then now the love of the father, the children don't show that love because of what the mother has told. Now here, Rebecca was staying with Jacob home while Hazel was going out, was going to the field, was going to look for something. And he injected him with the poisonous that even Hazel can die, doesn't care. But he wants Jacob. He loved Jacob and the father loved Hazel. So now we see that Rebecca said that now let your curse fall upon me. Just listen my voice. Go and get it. Get them for me. So he went and got them and brought them to his mother, and his mother made the delicious food that his father loved. Rebecca took her older son, his favorite clothes that were in the house with her, and she put them on her young son Jacob on his arms and smote his neck. They put the hide of young goats and the delicious food and the bread she had made, she put it on her son's hand. Now Rebecca went and got the clothes of his son, Hazel, and put it to Jacob because the clothes has a smell of Hazel. So that when Isaac would smell, he would hear the smell of Hazel. You see, that it was a trick. That it was a very bad trick. God help women. God help mothers. Then now, the problem here is, Isaac was sensitive. He said, I can hear the voice of the voice is not of my son Isa, but it sounds like Jacob. But Jacob said, no, I am Isa. So now you see, here is the thing that I want to clear to you. Jacob suffered 20 years. Jacob suffered so much working for Laban. He worked like a slave, but God was with Jacob. Now, God Almighty would forgive mothers. Mothers who makes their children to hate their fathers. And then the fathers put a curse. If you don't know how to come out from this curse, these children would be dying in the streets. They would be shooting in the street and die. They become criminals. Look at them, the single mothers, especially mothers who have denied their children to see their fathers. The father curse their children and the curses work. Because you can see there's a curse which Jacob feared so much. And the mother said, let it come to me. But the curse will go to you and the children. The wicked father will curse you and the children. So I pray that any curse that your father and mother, that your father has cursed you and your children, let it be broken in Jesus' name. I pray every curse that has been placed on you by your husband, by fathers and children, let these curses be broken in Jesus' name. I know that there was a curse which was issued to Jacob. Now, look at that. Jacob, who understood the curses, he cursed his own son. He curses his own son. Jacob, the one who understands, Jacob, a man of God. Jacob, the one we read the Bible, God of Jacob. He is the one who put a big curse to his son. And his son, God delivered him through Moses. Now, let's look at the book of Genesis 49, verse 3 to 4. You can see Jacob, who feared the curse, now is the one cursing his own child. You see, the father have a very terrible curse that he can curse the children, and the children will not excel. This is why I want to tell parents, I want to tell single mothers, I want to tell mothers, I want to talk to you. I know that you have problem with your husband. You know the problem with the father's children. I know you have a problem with the father's children. I want you, please, your problem is not that, it's not the children. Let the children see their father. Let the children love their father so that they can get the blessings of father. Now, you see, Reuben, the Bible says in the book of Genesis 49, verse 3 to 4, you shall not excel. Reuben, you are my firstborn, my might and the beginning of my strength, the excellence of my dignity, and the excellence of power, unstable as water. You shall not excel because you went up to the father's bed. Then you divide it. You went up to my couch. You see, now, Jacob was so bitter with his son, and he issued a curse over his son. Jacob, who feared, Jacob of all the people, Jacob, he knows, he understand, he knew how the curses would impact, would destroy his own son. He didn't care. He had so many sons. So that is what is happened. Curses can be issues from the father. There is power from the mouth of the father. So we pray that God will deliver the children from the curses of the father. In the name of Jesus. My God, my father, in the name of Jesus Christ, I pray any curse that has been placed from the father affecting the children, let this curse be destroyed in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray that any curse that is affecting the children right now from the fathers, let this curse be destroyed in Jesus' name. I thank God that God, who uses Moses to break the curse of Reuben, when Moses saw that Reuben is going to die, Reuben has been cursed, Moses went there and break the curse. Jesus is here to break every curse that has been blessed to you from your fathers. Every curses, Jesus has broken them. Jesus has taken the curses so that you can be free in the name of Jesus. I pray that God will deliver children who are under the curse of their fathers. In the name of Jesus Christ, I pray that God, my Father, in the name of Jesus, this time, Lord, we bring the children to you, God, and I break and cancel all the curses that is affecting the children from their fathers. In the name of Jesus Christ, my God and my Father, I pray that God, let the blessings fall upon the children who are under the curses of their father. I break them. I break the children. I break anybody who is under the curses of their father. Because the father can curse the wife and the children. Rebecca was cursed because she made Jacob enter into sin. So the curse went to Rebecca. Now Rebecca was cursed with Jacob. But Jacob, he understood how to cry to God and repent. And he prayed so hard. That's why God had to have mercy upon him. And Jacob was fighting. He never stood. He never lived alone. He was fighting. He was working hard to receive the blessings that God has promised him. Therefore, children who do not live in a godly way, who does not know God, they live without curses. That's why you see many children are wandering. They are suffering. They sometimes wish my father can talk to me. Father, sometimes father is dead, it's not there. He breathed a curse and it's gone. So this curse is still tormenting you. Unless you find a man of God or a woman of God to break these curses, there's many children who are under the curse of their father, who placed a big curse on them. Father, you know, the curse, this curse works. Even if you see the book of Exodus, where God says that the curses of your forefathers, the book of Lamentation said our father sins and they are not there. So now you see the fathers, there is power in the father. So the father can sin and leave the children with that sins, with that curses. The father can curse their children and leave the children with that curses. Then the curses will continue tormenting the children, passing to generation to generation because of the curse that was pressed to their children. I pray that God Almighty would have mercy on you and destroy every curses that has been placed on you by your father. If your father is alive or is dead, just go and ask your heavenly father by through the blood of Jesus to forgive you. Ask the forgiveness of your father. Go and kneel down. Even you woman, if you know that you are under the curse of your husband, go and ask God to forgive you. Because this curse has worked and you have no idea. Your children, they will be wondering, there is no blessings that flow in the children. Children are being in prison. Children are being abused. Children are scattered. They are vulnerable. They turn themselves to all everything because of the curses that was pressed to them by their father. I pray that God will forgive you and God will break every curses. Jesus will destroy every curses that has been blessed in you by the power in his blood. I destroy and bind out all the curses that is working against your life and your children in Jesus' name. I pray that God will forgive you. Go ahead and repent. Ask the Lord to forgive you. This is deliverance prayer for the children and mothers. Mothers, you have been under heavy curses of your husband because you influenced the children and the children hate their father. Because of that, the father was so angry and he put a big curse on you and your children. So the children have been suffering and been attacked, and because of these curses the father has placed on them. So I pray that God will break every curses. Yes, this topic I will change it. The Lord will break every curses that the father has blessed on you in the mighty name of Jesus. Your father, that every curses that he has blessed on your life, the curses that is crying against you, let it be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Every curses that is crying against you, let it be broken in Jesus' name. I destroy them by the power in the blood of Jesus. I break them and I destroy them. I pray that God will help you in Jesus' name. The Father, they have the blessings. Now, you see, the Father blessed Jacob instead of Esau. So now you see there is a blessing the father has. Jacob called his children. Let's look in the book of Genesis 49. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. The book of Genesis 49. Genesis 49, you see, even Genesis 27. Here he said that I am hedged. I am hedged and I'm about to die. So I want to bless you. Now, there is a blessing the father has. This one we don't have to argue. We don't have to say what. This is the blessing that God has put to a father. So the father said, I'm not going to die and I can bless you. I know I can bless you and you will prosper. You have to go to your father. You have to do good to your earthly father. You have to show your father love. Yes, your father might have problem with your mother, but he doesn't have problem with you. Even if he has a problem with you, humble yourself. The Bible says in Ephesians 6, verse 1 to 4, he said, children, obey your parents so that your days can be long. There also he said, children, obey your parents so that your days can be long. Now, that there you will know, if you don't obey your parents, children, your days will not be wrong. The day will be shortened. That's the Bible, the word of God. And now the parents, they understood about that. And that you have no idea. Children who rebel upon their fathers, who rebel upon their husband, their parents. So remember that obedience is better than sacrifice. Children who are obeying their parents, their life will be stable. Their life will be blessed. But the ones who does not obey the parents, their life will never be good. They will never see any good. They will suffer everywhere they go. They will never be happy. Yes, you know, I know for sure that a mother is the chief in the house. When it's remaining, the mother who takes care when the father is not there is the chief of the children. So he takes care of the children. She has more time with children than the father. Because most the father, they are working. Even in case the fathers who takes care of children, watch this. Sometimes you find the father takes care of children. Maybe the wife is working and the father is not working. And then something happened. You see that the father, the children will go to the side of the father and they will start to hate the mother. That is because the father stayed with the children more time than the mother. Now, because of that, the father also talks to the children. When the mother done something wrong with the father, with the mother, he tells his children, your mother is doing this and this to me. And the children feel that the mother is a bad person. That's how it is. But mostly it's the mother who takes care of the children than the father. Any father who takes care of the children and gossip the mother against their children, that father also, he can cause the children to suffer, because the Bible says obey the parents. Let us look at that scripture from the book of Genesis 49. Hallelujah. The book of Genesis 49. Thank you, Jesus. I want to show you something about Jacob. Jacob of all of the people. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. My God, I want to bless your name. Thank you, Father. Jacob called his sons to bless them. You see, Jacob calls his son to bless them. And Jacob called unto his sons and said, gather yourself together that I may tell you that which shall I befall you in the last days. Gather yourselves together and hear ye, sons of Jacob, and hearken unto Israel your father. Reuben, thou art my firstborn, my might, and the beginning of my strength, the excellence of dignity, and the excellence of power, and step as water, that shalt thou excel, because thou wentest up to thy father's bed, that then defiest thou it. He went up to my court. Now here, Jacob is calling his children to bless them. That's why I want to emphasize to you, there is blessings of the father. Father has blessings to his children. So don't pray with your father. Make sure you get the blessings from your father. Even if your father is a drunkard, is what? You see, when this man, there's a man called he drank, then he strips his clothes and become naked. And his sons, when they come and see him naked, one of them laughed, and went away. And the other one, when he saw his father is naked, his father is naked, what he did, he went backward and covered the father. When the father woke up from drink, what did he do? He cast the one who laughed at him and they blessed the one who covered him. So you see, there is a blessings of the father. And the father understood how to issue the curses. Therefore, we pray that God would break every curse that has been placed on you. God would have mercy because of ignorance. Children, I'm talking to you. Mothers, tell your children, if you know that you have been gossiping your husband with your children, you repent. And talk, if your children can go and see the father, let them go and see the father and repent and become sorry for what they have done. Then God will bless them and their life will come. This is the commission. That's how God declared them. God has power over the fathers to bless their children. Parents have power to bless their children. So don't let your mother, your father die without your blessing you. If they have gone already, you can ask God to, you can ask God to forgive you. Go to your pastor. The pastor is representative of your father. Look at that Ephesians. Now I'm coming to the Ephesians 6. You see, you might not have the father, or you are a single, you are fatherless, or you are a single mother, and you have no father. You have no husband, you have children, the father is not there or is dead. You can go to your pastor. Let me show you something here. I'm going to close this soon. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. my God and my Father. Ephesians 6. Thank you, Jesus. The Bible says, Ephesians 6, verse 1. The Bible says, children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is the right. Honor the father and mother, which is the first commandment with promises, that it may be well with thee, and thou may live long on the earth. And ye fathers, provoke not your children to wrath, but bring them up in the nurture and admonition to them, to the Lord. Now here, the first one is the one that I want to focus on it. The Bible says, children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is the right thing. So the parents in the Lord, they are your pastors, they are your bishops, they are your prophets, they are your spiritual mother and spiritual father. If you have no father right now, you need to go to the spiritual father, a spiritual mother who is a parent, who is representing your father, your parents, to bless you, to break the curses that you have been undergoing. You need to call your pastor. You need to take your children to your pastor. All the children, you have to go to your pastor, and your pastor will pray for you on behalf of your father, because your father is not there. Maybe he's gone, or you can't find him. You don't know where he is in the world, and you know that your life has been miserable. This is a blessing you need. The pastor will present you to the throne of God, and God will bless you. They will be broke. They will break the curses. Many children are suffering because they were cursed by their fathers. I pray that this Father's Day, let children be blessed. Let your family be blessed. Let be blessed in the name of Jesus. I pray that God will break every curses, will destroy every curses affecting the children, will destroy anything that the father has put in his children, in the name of Jesus Christ. The father, even they get bitter, they go to witchcraft and they curse the children. I have seen a father who wanted to whip the children. Because of bitterness, sometimes even the father can go and kill the wife and children, because he can't take it. That's how it is. But I pray that God will destroy and break every bitterness and every curse that has been placed to your life by your husband, by the father of your children, in Jesus' name. Thank you very much. God bless you. This is your host, Prophetess Dr. Christine Sick, saying bye-bye to you. Happy Father's Day once again. I pray that you could become a good father. Don't curse your children. Even if your children have done you something wrong, it's your children. Don't put a curse to your children. Love them and bless them. Also, God will bless you. I pray that, thank you so much, and God will bless you, will bless you, will bless you. Happy, happy, happy Father's Day. I wish all the sons happy, 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 happy Father's Day. And the children that are growing, as they will become man, they are youth, and the God will bless them. And I pray that every curse start working against them, let it be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Thank you very much. God bless you. Go to our website at www.overcomersdhministries.blogspot.ca. You can reach us through this call, number 607-647-608-5207. We have our number 905-487-7196. So you can reach me by calling this number. We have prayer line. I'll see what would happen next week. We would have prayers tonight and tomorrow. We'll have prayer on Tuesday, 4 o'clock. I will come Tuesday, 4 o'clock. So if you come, I think I'm going to see if we are going to use prayer line midnight. But I will see how it will go. Resend the videos. Don't call me and ask me, is there any prayer? I have announced and I've said. But if you want to get information, yes, you can call me. And I will tell you that we don't have prayers today evening. Midnight, we don't have prayers. We will have prayers on Tuesday, 4 o'clock. 4 o'clock, I will tell you if we are going to continue doing prayer conference, and I'll let you know. But the prayer line will be on. What I'm avoiding is distraction from Periscope. You can see what they are saying now. They are cursing and saying things that is not glorifying God. I know the children of the devil has been pressed there to bring destruction. They are not my friend. They are not Christian. They are the agents of the devil. But because the devil has assigned them, they bring destruction. Now, we will have time for honorary prayer conference. We will not be appear in Periscope. So, Periscope, people, you will come on our website. The videos will be there. When I finish the prayer like this, I will upload the video so you don't have to worry about. If you don't have long distance, you can always receive the blessings on the from YouTube, from our website. So God bless you so much. Have a wonderful time and enjoy Father's Day. Take them out, feed them, let them sit down like kings and feed them. That's they're there. Let them enjoy. And let them enjoy their children and the wife and the grandchildren and be happy. Thank you very much. God bless you. Have a wonderful day, Father's Day. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you once again. I'm saying bye-bye to you. Bye. Bye-bye. Bye. Bye.
Bye.